get into the mindset of it?
Yeah, or maybe into the physicality of it. When you're prepping for voiceover, how is it different from prepping for another kind of scene that you might be doing?
Well, I'm fortunate to have that voiceover because, you know, as, from an actor's perspective, you're always trying to figure out what your subconscious is doing.
Oh, yeah. And it's right there.
And I got it. So what's fun is having that, and then as it's great to have that, and then play against it, because it's like, what can I do in the scene that is opposite of what is going on in my head? The way we all do in real life, you know, there's all those voices we have in our heads, we're trying to mask constantly, and especially Elliot is putting out this, you know, certain persona. Or hiding so much, so it's nice to look at it on the page and go, that's voiceover. Now do the opposite sometimes. Or, yeah, it's fun because you get to try, I can try so many different things. And I know how it's gonna sound in the voiceover. I always do the voiceover almost, you know, a few days after we wrap an episode, so it's all fresh in my head. And by the time I go in there and like, it's a black, you know, just a dark sound stage and go in there, have it all almost memorized by then because I've heard it after every take in my ear, and it's just, it's nice. I can go back to the scene where I was, think about, you know, what take we really liked and kind of stuck with, and you know, it's pretty nuanced in there is how I'm reading that VO. But
during, like,